Hello.
How has being in Sweden changed?
How has it changed my life? It's changed my life in the sense that it's kind of made it more rewarding to kind of walk down the road and have someone come up to you and say, I really like Skins or I really like Sid. It's kind of, I don't really think about it. It's just made me more confident as a person, I suppose. And it's just been a good experience. It's kind of got me into something that I've wanted to do all my life, and now I'm finally doing it, basically.
You're doing it really well.
Thank you.
So what would you be doing now if you weren't
doing it? Right now, all my mates are texting me, so I'm probably at the pub. But I don't really know. I would be going off to university, I suppose, in September or whatever, but I've never really thought about it. I'm lucky enough not to have to think about it now, no. I wouldn't say I'm famous. I don't know the whole fame thing, but what's the best thing I've been able to buy? I've been behind a bar at a club. I've been at a club before, and they've kind of recognised me, and they've kind of said, oh, come behind the bar. And I've ended up serving a few drinks to people, which has kind of been a bit random, but it's been good. Yeah, different.
Do people sometimes expect you to be just like Sid?
According to all my mates, I basically am Sid. So they just kind of take it as they are. I just play myself as I am myself. So if I come across as Sid, I come across as Sid. If I come across as Mike, I come across as Mike. So.
And if you wrote the script, what would you like to see Sid do
next? I did put it forward for the second series that every single episode, Sid should be doing a different extreme sport. So paragliding, bungee jumping. So, I mean, more of that, basically. But, I mean, Sid's got a good thing going on for him, so I don't really think I'd change that much, to be honest with you, except for the whole extreme sport thing.
So that's actually happening.
Extreme sports, unfortunately not. I put it forward and they declined it.
Okay. If you could play any other character, who would it be and why?
Probably Anwar. Thing is, it's just that he has the best lines. Anwar has basically been wrote after Dev, who plays Anwar now, because he basically fits the bill. He is the same person. So I'll probably be him, just he gets the good lines, he gets to have the best laughs. He just has a good time with it, basically.
Okay, and what do you think Sid will be doing in 20 years' time?
Oh, good question. I don't really know. I mean, it depends how his life progresses. If he's kind of going at the state he was at between episode one, in series one, sorry, he kind of wouldn't be doing much, kind of be a bit of a bum, or he could have actually proved himself to people and actually do something with his life. So I think he's actually going to come out of himself in 20 years' time. He's actually going to be doing something with his life and proving himself.
If you could choose any celeb to make a cameo appearance on the next series of Skins, who would it be and why?
All those people.
So many choices.
Jessica Alba, just so I could stare at her all day. And of course, would you like to be in the second series? You should have a cameo. You should talk to our producer and just get you in there. Go on. You've done this so well, you should get in there.
Okay, so who is the most famous person on your mobile phone?
Most famous person on my mobile phone? Probably Nick. That's about it. Yeah, I'm getting dodgy stares around me at the moment. Is someone else said that as well?
Everyone.
It is basically Nick. Who's Nick said? I know he's got Badly Drawn Boy on his phone.
Oh,
I know he's got him.
You should get it.
I'll nick it, yeah. I've just got Nick, really. It's not bad, he's famous. I've got the whole cast of Skins on my mobile phone.
Have you ever Googled yourself? And if so, find anything interesting?
Yes, I have. And if you just type in Michael Bailey, I think it comes up with like a professor or something. If you type in Mike Bailey Sid, it comes up with a bit more about me. I'm on Wikipedia, I found. But if you just type in my name, it's pretty boring stuff. It's, you know, professors and stuff in America, nothing interesting. Have you ever Googled yourself? You have, haven't you? Yes. You gotta be doing it.
Has fame helped your pudding technique?
I've got a girlfriend.
Who?
And I've been going out of her since like the second week it's been on. So, I mean, I haven't really used it as a technique, but I'm sure if I was single, it might help me a little bit.
And have there been any real life or romances?
All the boys fell in love.
Fell
No. There's been, we try and keep it as professional as we can, so no one kind of has any bits. But no, not to my knowledge. If there has been, I want to know. Do you know anything? Has anyone else said anything? Have they said anything about me?
Oh, everyone fancies you.
Of course. How can you not? I'm joking. No.
Okay. What's going to keep Skins going, and what can we expect in the series?
I think the storyline's going to keep it going. It's going to be new, fresh. It's just going to be good. I don't know what to expect from the second series, I haven't told. So, I mean, it's just, they've said expect good things. So, it's just going to be bouncy and everything. It's just look forward to it, really.
Okay, Mike, Sid is quite a downtrodden character. How would you personally stand up to Tony and, well, bag Michelle?
I'd just put him in his place.
How would you do that?
Oh, I don't know. I'd just kind of say, right, you're being like this to me. I'm not having it anymore. Back off. You've got no one. But, I mean, it depends. If you're talking about it in the middle of series one, it's different at the end because he's probably dying. So...
Your character's aim is to lose his virginity. What advice would you give to someone of your own age who feels pressure to lose his or her virginity?
Just let it come. Let it, not in that sense. Let it just come along. Let it happen. It'll take its toll. You know, it'll take its toll. It'll happen, basically. Just, you know, play it steady. Find the right girl. Don't just lose it at some random party like everyone does. Although you probably will. That might be the best way of losing it. You might regret it like most people do, but just let it happen. It'll happen one day. Probably not that good. Don't listen to my advice.
Finally, your character got beaten up a lot in the first series. Did you suffer any real injuries?
When we were doing the chav fight and the girls beat me up, I was kicked a few times. I think the worst injury came to Dev, whose foot got run over. In the first episode, when Nick pulls up and kind of goes round in the car, Dev got out too fast and the car went over his foot. So I wasn't as bad as that. I was pretty lucky. Larissa almost got a broken thumb. I just basically got kicked.
Not that bad.
Kind of hurt at the time, but, you know, I'm not going to gloss over it. Oh, that hurt. It was okay. If I had to swap bodies. Ooh. You've got to do it. I mean, it's the whole male thing. You've got to swap bodies with a woman. So I'd probably do one of the girls. I don't know which one. Just for the fact that I'd probably have some fun with it. I'd try out things that I can't do as a male. Not pointing out anything in particular.
And do you ever lose the hat? And would you do that for us now?
In what sense? Oh, right, yeah. I can honestly say in series 2, Sid won't be wearing the hat as much. It's just because I've been up in the road for that long, sweating, hair's gone kind of bad. Thank you. I don't wear it in real life that much either.